Welcome to Analytics with Nax. In this video, I'm going to talk about Power BI release July 2023 as part of Catch Up with Nax Cities. Let's begin our today's content without wasting time. This channel contains free content and you can utilize this content, and it covers Power BI, MS BI and SQL and basic understanding of Azure as well. Please feel free to share this channel, and if you have any comments, please mentioned in description. Let's begin. So Power BI July release, and I'm posting it at the end of the month. That is fine. But what are the key things or new things that has released as part of this July 2023 release? That is what I'm going to highlight. There are a lot of other things that is not relevant or not mostly widely used. Whatever I prefer or I use personally in my day-to-day work, I'm going to explain that. That may be useful for someone else as well. That is the whole objective of this video. Let's go one by one. In the reporting side, there is a smooth and leader lines update. Like over here, like you can see leader lines. Launch of one of our most highly acclaimed features. Report creators can create smoother line and area charts, providing more polished look to their visualization. So this is what all about. And you can see you have option over here, smooth, right? Here you can mention it. And there is leader lines as well, where you can see you can mention these lines as a leader lines, then you can have your values appear on top. So this will make your visualization look much better. That is the whole concept about this smoother and leader lines. And on object interaction preview updates, so it's still under preview. What they did is like they can customize the pan switcher, because it will be very difficult earlier. Once you have some panes, I mean on object interaction, you can have only few things are checked out. Here you have options. Right now you can select what are the things you can able to choose in that panes, right? That is one of the customize your pane switcher option they have enabled. And this is something like earlier they don't have option to choose the colors for the tree map. Now it has one, as usually I say, top three features of any one release. This is one of the first one I like: modeling, edit your data model in the Power BI service updates preview. So this I'm going to create another dedicated video. Basically what it says is like you have a modeling, and mostly till now, or maybe till April of 2023, no one can edit the model in the Power BI service. But you can able to edit in the model when you want to do a quick fix, you can do it. I strongly object that doing it directly in the Power BI service, because you always have some version in your local or your version control systems or DevOps, so that you can publish from the publish to the Power BI service. But sometimes we may think like that takes long time, and it was very quick measure. You want to do it, you have demos, all other stuff, so you can use this feature. I will demonstrate how you can enable it and what is the advantage of in a separate video. Basically you can edit modeling, you can create measure, you can create calculated column, or you can create a relationship that in the services. That is the core part of it. Then there is a lot of connectivity issues, I mean connectivity updates. Basically they fix a lot of other things over here. And finally, like dataset details page revamp. So now there is some, after the upgrade to Fabric, there are a lot of confusions, and they revamp the page, how it looks like. That is what this is all about. And the second feature I like here is like the mobiles. In the mobile, you can update the data set. This is another important to me, because a lot of time what happens is like we are the usually the data set will be refreshed once a day or twice a day, but there will be a lot of changes at the backend side that is depend on some other team or someone has to update it, and we need to manually refresh it. At that time, I may not be in my desk, I will be with the customer or some other meetings, whatever. So they need to literally wait until this data set, I mean someone to refresh if they want a quick, instead if it is not, it falls on the schedule. So if I have in my mobile, I can do it right now. In my mobile, if someone pings me, it is done, can you refresh? I can go to my mobile, I already have logged in, and you can refresh it. This feature is not there till now, and it is very important update, so we can refresh our data set on the go. So this is very good feature. And developers, all other things are visualization. One of the visual I want to highlight is, like, this is another important visual. I personally tried it, it was very good. We are ready to present new visual, all in one multi-target KPI card. So you can have multiple targets in this card. That is what this visual is all about. Where there are, you can go through this visual, I mean other visuals as well. I hope that's it. So few things, again I will repeat. One is a very important thing is, like, you can update your data set in a mobile, and you can edit your model in the Power BI services. This is what I like in this release. If you like this video and if you have any questions, please comment below. And if you are not subscribed to this channel, please do the subscribe button. Please do remember that data is your asset.